The plant pictured here is Prunus avium, the sweet cherry. Sweet cherry is a tree that is conical to cylindrical in shape and can get 50 to 70 feet tall. It is deciduous. The bark is quite distinctive. It's typically a reddish-brown color with very prominent horizontal raised lenticels. With age, the bark may become a more silvery gray color as shown here, and the lenticels begin to merge together to form longer horizontal ridges. Prunus avium has alternate leaf arrangement, and the leaves are elliptic with an acute to acuminate leaf apex. The leaf margin is serrate, but the leaves of Prunus avium have a few other distinct traits that can help you narrow it down at least to the genus. First, if you look at the petiole, you'll notice that it's canaliculate. There's a deep groove in it. And then right at the junction of the petiole and the leaf blade, you'll see a pair of glands. These glands are fairly large. We call them warty glands, and they're usually a dark red color. Now, all species of Prunus have glands on the leaves somewhere. But on Prunus avium, they are fairly large pair of glands, again, right where the leaf blade and the leaf petiole come together. Prunus avium is also in the rose family, so it will have floral parts in multiples of five, and the flowers are white in color. So here you can see these white flowers with five petals. They're usually about an inch to an inch and a half in diameter. These flowers come out in the spring, just as the new leaves are beginning to come out as well. And here you can see the fruits. The fruits are borne on pedicels that are a couple of inches long, and they're considered drupes. When the fruit first develop, they will be a bright red color, and later they'll darken to the reddish-purple color that we're all familiar with. And with that, we conclude our discussion of Prunus avium, the sweet cherry.